In the name of God, the most gracious, the most kind, the most merciful. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My prayer is that God Almighty preserve us all in peace, understanding, and happiness. First, we have prepared here a speech oftentimes, you know, but first let me respond. I said that one to the supply. Oh, I've got to wait to close this program, otherwise you can go in. But to our good friend, to convey to our friend, the good governor of Ceremonies, that federalism is the future. It is not the era. In fact, one of the reasons why they are fighting him around is that this so-called era has never had an impact. Never had an impact on the community. And in that, indeed now, not only the pockets of corrupt politicians, but it's now made as part of their tertiary, their personal spendings. These are things that we have to address. And I'm happy also, and then acknowledge, in fact, I've said the kind of introduction we made that mentioning about the World National Liberation Front. No regrets. We have given our best. And if you have to do it again, we will. But it was during the Sambuanga siege that the mainstream World National Liberation Front, whose leaders are here with us today, who compelled to take over the Moro National Liberation Front chairmanship after the siege, that tragedy, which we condemned in the highest, in the possible, strongest possible term. And we took over so it might help, and it helped diffuse that temper at the time. Otherwise, it could be another war, because my friends, war is no longer an option for us. What happened in Malawi is a failure of everyone, a failure of our government, and a failure of our own system that's not working. We are in the 21st century, and the kind of government that we have still holds strongly the business of the colonial past that have created this great divide between you and me. We have to dismantle it for the safety and same future of our children and grandchildren to be. It is on this premise that we are thanking you most kindly, but I would rather have the former Deputy Secretary, Under Secretary of the Department of Government, Mr. Leto Monico Lorenzana, who is now the prime mover of the Chess Movement for Federal Philippines, likewise Dr. Rosario Manasan, the PIDS Senior Fellow, Dr. Robert Emmanuel Miral, Jr., the Director General of the CPPRD, Attorney, well, they have left earlier, but nevertheless we are thanking him, Attorney Benedicto Makani, Ramon Bale of the Ateneo de Sambuanga, Political Science Department Chairman, likewise Benedicto Kaplan of Sambuanga del Sur, Provincial Home, Jonathan Malayan, of course our good friend, becoming more of the social the nationwide, the nation's spokesman of Federalism. And Dr. Akram Latif, Minmas Professor, Dr. Alexander Kampane, Dr. Hussein Bidasan of UP, Urban Planning Center, who happens to be a consultant of the Mineral Development Authority, part of any preparation of reorganization programs that we have in Mindanao. And Dr. Mary Jules Quinto Sali, our MSU Tarikawi Chancellor, was here. And Director Minda Morante, also the regional director. Mr. Rafael Eric Gallian, the MSU Sulu Campus Secretary and Vice Chancellor, Administration of Finance. We also said, ato may nag-in sa Marimbo before Mexican security army. Likewise, the detector and then the others were, and you, my good friends, are here. First and foremost, let me extend our warmest congratulations to all the men and women who were tirelessly to make this event possible. To the Philippines of Development Studies, attending the San Juan University, and our fellow colleagues in the Mindanao Development Authority. Bear in mind that the hard work that you have displayed these past few days will pave the way to a better future for Mindanao and for the rest of the country. Our operation also extends to our partners and participants in this activity, the knowledge and inputs that you have shared during this span of this oral history in Palawan. May I speak, because it seems to be in the national penalty, the parents speak of what I had to pay after listening together. And then listening to what, and then to what we have heard today. Self-denial, if you will let me talk about Marawi. Marawi was the center of government under the American colonial rule. It prides itself, in fact, of having the first group course in the country, particularly in the size of Mindanao. The country club managed and maintained by the Manila Hotel. These are things from the past under the American rule. It also hosts kilometer 0.00, the reference of all roads in Mindanao and the center of government. As they say at the time, there are only three high schools in the country that can compete with Hawaii. And that was the Camp John Hay High School in Baguio City, the UP High in Padre Power, and the Lanao High in what was then Dan Salam, now Marawi City, Marawi City. It was beautiful, setting this beautiful setting. One of the 15 oldest lakes, one of the 15 ancient lakes in the world, but one of the 5 oldest of these 15 lakes. Perhaps, I don't know which is inside, Manchuria or us, is the oldest lake. Nevertheless, I'm saying this, because while we were in Russia, Marawi was under siege, started fighting. We were guilty, in fact, as I have said, all of us, because in negligence, we never believed that this would happen, and it can happen in our own backyard, in our own hometown. But it happened anyway. But if you dig deeper, what they will tell you. Particularly in this year. And now it becomes more dangerous because the ideologues have taken over the leadership. Because of the never-ending peace process. The longest running peace process in the world, which is even longer than the Palestinian-Israeli negotiation. So, what developments are you talking about and we are complaining about errors? We do not even know about these errors, but they know it's for kids bigger and it's a personal funds of the officials of government. Ensure no economic impact on their lives, no hopes. So, this is one thing. The system will never work. So there is no hope. So I cling on to that hope when there is no hope. Now what we are telling our people, don't lose hope. Cling on, hold on. Because hope is another form of worship to God. And this worship, God will be most kind that it will respond. It has responded. But we want it fast. But in the system of politics, you have to accept. When I was listening, you are not talking about 5 years, 6 years, 8 years, transition and all of these things. It makes me feel so insecure. It was what we wanted. As when I asked the president, I have to go and see this railway system as they have offered us. Ano si testingan mo? Sabi ko, hindi mo ang 83. Sa sakit na yun. Subukan natin. That is the right time. Subukan natin. I mean, I return back with the model set by the government of China. And I give it to the president. Like a child, on a fleeting moment, was looking and not saying, kung maski lang dalawang kilometro dito, magawa natin agad. Mabuti na, kaya ko na gusto ko ng mamatay ako, okay na sa akin. Sabi ko, no, we are going to finish this because they assured me in 4 years' time that what they have done with the Shanghai Beijing railway system, the high-speed railway system, 1,300 kilometers, they did it in 4 years. And they told me to rest assured that they can even do better than that. In short, even not even 4 years, they can do it. Which it is, as the best of explanations. These are the things the president wants, even 2 kilometers away, and he will be happy to go. No, sir. Mr. Doctor is called another 5 years. Give it another 2 years without the federalism. Forget it, gentlemen. It will happen. It will take time. You are talking about transition of 8 years or 5 years, forget it. The world, the Muslim community, have embraced democracy. But democracy in Islam simply means the rule of law. And when we embrace democracy, being a part of this country, the kind of rule of law that we have embraced, did not respond enough to our needs. That is precisely why the problem started. Looking at what they are talking about now in Congress, and I'm happy Mr. Malaya is here, and with the Philippine government, the prime mover for the Philippines, moving for federalism. If you look at it, and look at this kind of proposals that they are having right now, this is more of a decentralization, a delegation of power. It is no different from the autonomous government, where in unison we all agree that it is a failure. At this moment. Why? Even if you have the BBL and make it stronger, it will still be a failure without the federalism, without this shift, the federal system working, because the BBL will be swimming in an unfriendly water and it cannot survive and it will not survive. The only way for that law to survive is to immediately, without serendipity, without going to the left or the right, go straight and focus. Systemic shape to the federal system. Let's do it. Let's not take the left or the right, go straight there. Because that is the centerpiece of the program of President Rodrigo Duterte when this country impressed him and elected him as their president. Our system right now, and looking at it, what I am referring to as a federalism with the variations of that system, and that is a shared sovereignty. A shared sovereignty between the federal state, federal government, and the state and the federal states, where it will be established the domain of the federal government and the territory of the state government. Very to have encroaching on each other because both will be sovereign in their own respective domains. That is the essence of federalism, and that is the kind of law we will embrace. Not decentralization, not delegation of power, because any delegation of power, brothers and sisters, my good friends, anything that is delegated can be withdrawn, but is shared. Sovereignty, you cannot, because it states, not unless you dismantle the whole constitution of the country. These are the things that we wanted to convey, as we have conveyed the other day to the country. Transition of 5 to 7 years, I want to forget it. But perhaps God, in his divine wisdom and intervention, many things can happen. Corazon Aquino did it. I'm proud to say, because you were part of that that installed corazon aquino. There are so many millionaires in this country, but it is the manipulating oligarchs that always give us all this problem. And mind you, I'm proud to say, looking at these millionaires who have benefited so much from that system and this system, but the very people that cannot even share $100 or 100 pesos, but they kept talking. We were so scared because of their names and being big business. No, sir, I have contributed more than anyone of them. It all was gone at the point that I sacrificed the future of my children. At one point, nobody wanted, and I raised initially 6 million years ago for a protest movement, but I never complained. My family never complained. We supported, but we have withdrawn because it has not made good his commitment, their commitment to establish a stronger government. When I say about wisdom, God's intervention and corruption has pressed strongly. But the president said he will not do it because it's not done by President McKinnon establishing the revolutionary government. But any divine intervention, and if it happens, what can stop the president from establishing a revolutionary government? If the time will come, the demand for it, by all means, let's do it. Establish a revolutionary government as we have established. Martial law in Mindanao. Establish a revolutionary government and in 6 months' time, in 60 days, this can be done. Gather the brightest and the best in our community, the legal minds, these former Supreme Court justices who are still around, who in fact even subsisted during our fight and fighting for the creation of the law, the crafting of the BBL in Congress. I'm listening still, it clings to my mind and my ears, the words of former Chief Justice Pangaliban. If we are really bent on solving the problem, Congress now can sit as a constituent assembly in one session. One day, they can finish this and solve the problem in this country by working out, perfecting the infirmities of the Constitution to allow and accommodate the BBL. But that happened in the past, it's really gone. And now it is different. What we have, my good friends, is that we are, as mandated by law, we call for the convening of the old moral convention, starting with that, as with all the rest of the country, so that it will serve as a convergence of the positions of the two fronts, including all signed agreements between the government and the MNLF and the MLF. And also, to get the best and the brightest in our community, coming from the academy, from the legal profession, our women, our youth sectors, this one, they can talk the real stakeholders and wrap up the law, our own version of a state law, to be part of the federation, to be submitted to the constitutional commission or to Congress as a constituent assembly or to the consultative committee created by the president or to a revolutionary government if it happens. This is the divine intervention that happens that dreamers like us will be dreaming and hoping and praying for, that in 6 days you can have a new constitution. And in the 90th day, you can only talk about calling for a general election and submitting it to the people, because in the final analysis, at the end of the day, it is the people that can approve or reject the kind of decisions that we have. These are things and miracles that can happen, and it can happen, hopefully, as what we have told the National Economic Development Authority, as we wanted to convey to you and to Mr. Malay. Mindanao is ready and willing. We can do it and we will do it. Yes. All what we are asking you from your people in Luzon and the Visayas, particularly also the government instrumentalities like the National Economic Development Authority, allow us to thank for Mindanao. Let Mindanao thank for Mindanao. Because in one of these discourses that we had, we were told, and I was so flattered, why cannot Mindanao think small? why Mindanao thinks so big. We are thinking so big for the first time because we have a Mindanao president. And this Mindanao president, if we cannot do it in the next 5 years, forget it, gentlemen. We want to think big because this country has never been fair to Mindanao. We are talking about big projects that we want to implement, but look at it on national expenditures. Even under President Rodrigo Duterte, the only figure we reach in the entire country is 15%. For the first time, Mindanao is getting 15% of the national expenditure. Now, they clap their hands, because all those years and decades, Mindanao has only been given 9 to 11%, and they are lucky if they can get 11%. Every year of the governance in this country, every year, when under the law and the fiscal equity, that I like that way that our good brother have mentioned here, instead of equality, fiscal equity, under that equity, Mindanao should be receiving minimum of 34% of the entire national budget, the entire national expenditure. That is justice, but justice that we live and have. It is will be, God willing, inside under a federal system that we can have it. And my good board member friend, it will be you that will be dictating what are you going to do with your resources. San Juan del Sur is the richest province. Lanao del Sur is the poorest in the country. It hosts also the poorest municipality and the poorest barangay. But the region, as a whole, the poorest region is the autonomous regional government, the Aru territory. But under federal system, I assure you, my dear friends, that your good brothers in Mindanao can catch up with you. The longest will be 10 years because our resources is great. And all what we wanted is to have that authority. All what we wanted is a law that can cloud us to exploit and explore our own resources and use it for our own need and the need of our generations to come and our people. Because from day one, under this federal system, we will submit to the Constituent Assembly or to the Constitutional Commission. From day one, they must make it quite clear that all the revenues of the government coming from a resource, from our strategic minerals, including fossils and uranium, must be used for a free education, for a free medical care program, and affordable housing program for our people, because that is the only economy immediately that can have an impact on our people, making them feel that the resources of Mindanao, their own resources is theirs. Their own resources is there for their future, their children, and the betterment of their life too. These are the issues that we wanted, and it must be done by our thinkers and our people. And I know that if you support the president, there is a man that will do it for you. And God's wisdom and intervention, I pray that he enlightens us all so that we can have this federal system, not in 6 years, but in 6 months. Thank you and good day.
Thank you very much, Secretary Alonso. Indeed, this is a timely event to highlight the crucial discourse on the issue of federalism and decentralization. So, in behalf of the Philippine Institute of Development Studies and the Mindanao Development Authority and the Ateneo de Zamboanga University through the Ateneo Research Center, I would like to thank you all for coming over and for contributing actively in this forum. Indeed, this forum helped us emphasize the need for in-depth reflections and evidence-based analysis, not just on federalism, but also on decentralization reforms in general. Once more, thank you very much and good afternoon.